Yeah, I can remember how long this was. 8, 9 years old, somewhere along there. And I can remember seeing her do it. I guess she thought I wasn't old enough to, because she taught me to knit, but not to do the bulk. She had her own role then. She'd done her own spinning and everything. Raised her own sheep and marked her own wool, took it to the, it was a carding mill in Warrensburg at that time.
Hmm.
And they made it into rolls, and she had the spinning reel, and she had the reel that she made it into a skein. We lived right near a brook. And we'd take it right down to the washtubs, right down to the brook, the soft soap that we had made ourselves, and wash it, pound it out with a pounder. Wooden pounder, and rats it and everything right down there with the brook and lay it out to dry. She gathered her shoemaker, was one thing she used, and butternut carved. And she used to knit for the lumber camp. One day they had horses, they didn't have the trucks, they had the horses. There was a man that used to come around, his name was Joe Blair. He'd come around by foot with a pack basket. Take them out and take them there and take them in. She never knit none but the mittens on. But I said, if you can knit, you can knit anything. I knit vests for men, big men, and let me tell you, they're heavy. I knit a pair of buff mittens in a couple of minutes. I'd just sit right there and knit, and when I'd get one done, I'd throw it to him and he'd start flipping, I'd start the next one. We used to use grain sack.
Hmm.
Grain came in a pretty sack. We'd get enough of one kind to make it the back of the quilt. I like to keep the art going.